Aloha everyone! Registration is right around the corner, and although it is only November, it is time to begin planning for next school year. In this flip book presentation created by one of our counselors, Christina Subiono, I will be covering the following topics listed here to help you navigate through the registration process. Let's begin. Choosing the right classes is important because you need to make sure you're on track to graduate. If you are interested in playing collegiate level sports, be sure to contact our college and career counselor, Mr. Miles Okoji. He can put you in the right direction to make sure you're taking the right classes. Various colleges have different admission requirements, which means you may need to check what their admission requirements are. Some colleges require 3 years of foreign language or 1 year of fine arts. As you start planning what to take, be sure to consider the type of college or university you want to attend and select classes that meet their requirements. Depending on the type of school, you may want a rigorous course schedule with classes that require you to spend a lot of time and effort throughout your high school years. Of course, you should take classes that are interesting to you or those that you are curious about. It's not always about what classes your friends are taking. Rather, try something different if you get a chance. You won't know if you will like it until you try it. The Hawaii Department of Education graduation requirements are listed here. They are also accessible on our registration site. Basically, to graduate with a high school diploma, you need a minimum of 24 credits. There are specific course requirements that must be met. For example, you need 4 credits of English and social studies, a minimum of 3 credits of math and science, 2 credits of either world language, fine arts, or career and technical education, 1 credit of PE, 0.5 credit of health and PTP, personal transition plan, and 6 credits of general electives. A credit tracker can help you check if you are on track for graduation. By recording which credits you have earned from your unofficial transcript, you will have a better idea of which courses you still need to take. If you have questions about filling out your credit tracker, email your counselor. As you begin the registration process, you will need to select an academy. Once you have chosen a field of study, you can begin to lay out the courses required or recommended for that academy. The academy elective progressions, also known as the programs of study, are listed in the registration guide and are also available on our registration site. In fact, once you choose an academy, you can click on a link that will take you to the page that has the courses in sequence that you will need to take. As you begin to select your classes, keep in mind that if you are interested in graduating with an honors recognition certificate, you will need to know the requirements for these distinctions. To become a valedictorian, you will need a cumulative GPA of 4.0 and have met one of the following recognition certificates. Academic honors requires a minimum cumulative GPA of 3.0, 4 years of math and science, along with 2 credits of advanced placement, running start, or early college. Career and technical education honors requires a minimum cumulative GPA of 3.0, 2 years of a sequential program of study with a B or higher in each class, and meeting or exceeding proficiency on a performance-based assessment related to your CTE academy. STEM honors requires a minimum cumulative GPA of 3.0, 4 years of math and science, along with a successful completion of a STEM capstone project. AP classes. Here is a list of AP classes offered next year. Taking an AP class requires commitment and dedication. It allows you to challenge yourself, gain stronger academic skills, broaden college and career choices, and possibly earn college credit depending on the score you earn on the national AP test. Be sure to complete the AP memorandum in the registration form if you would like to take an AP course. If you have questions about the course, email the teacher. To modify your schedule, you will need to be a senior and have a minimum cumulative GPA of 2.0 and 21 credits. You will also need to complete the modified day contract in the registration Google form. Your counselor will review your request for modified day after you submit your form and will discuss your options with you. Your parents must approve of your request to modify your schedule. To be a teacher assistant, you must be either a junior or a senior and have a minimum cumulative GPA of 2.0. Juniors must have 14 credits and seniors must have 18 credits. Juniors can TA for one teacher while seniors can TA for two teachers. Email the teacher for approval before you fill out the registration form. If you are interested in Running Start or Early College classes, both offer opportunities to earn dual high school and college credits. Email Mr. Miles Okoji to find out how you can take advantage of this opportunity. If you are interested in credit recovery, the next Twilight session will begin in January. Contact your counselor for more information. eSchool is also available for those who would like to take one course per year for credit recovery or advancement. Contact your counselor to sign up. Registration is a time to begin planning for the future. Get a head start and review our Kapolei High School registration site. Email or phone your counselor if you have specific questions. Talk to your teachers to get advice and recommendations. Don't wait until the last minute to submit your form. Take the time to plan for your future.